Hey, coin collectors, and welcome to DC Coin World International Coin Channel. And it's a 1963 Franklin half dollar, the last year they made the Franklin half before they started up with the Kennedy. And we're looking at it right here, and we see Franklin on the front facing to the right. It says Liberty above his head, in God we trust under his chin, under all of them, actually. And then if we tip it up way, way up here, we see a J, an R, and an S. And that's for John R. Sinek. Actually, you probably know him because he was the engraver of the United States nickel. And so when you see that JS under the nickel, you know that that is the same guy, the same John Sinek. These coins were made from 1948 until 1963. They made them at three different mints, but in 63, there were only two mints that made them. The Philadelphia Mint, which has no mint mark above it, and the Denver Mint, which has the D mint mark above it. The San Francisco Mint did make them, and there's a San Francisco Mint S right up there, but they stopped making them in 1954. After that, it was all the Denver and Philadelphia Mints. So how many did they make in Philadelphia in 1963? Well, they made quite a few. I don't think they knew, well, they didn't know, of course, that they weren't going to go after 1963. In November of 1963, President Kennedy was assassinated, and so they decided to put him on the half-dollar coin. And in order to do that, of course, it took them a little while, but in order to do that, they had to get rid of the Franklin half. And so that's what happened here. At Philadelphia, again, they made 67 million. At Denver, they made 35.5 million. So they made about 100 million of these when they last came out. How does that contrast to 1964? Well, in 1964, when the Kennedy halves came out, this is a 71, but in 64, when the Kennedy halves came out, they made 277 million. At Philly, and 156 million at Denver. So they made a little bit under 450 million. So they made a lot more. What's the story with these? Well, I believe that in 1948, that was the 200th anniversary of the birth of Ben Franklin. And so that's where these coins came from. It says United States of America at the top, E Pluribus Unum over here. There's the bell, and you can actually see some of the words on the bell, Philadelphia, and I don't know, some of this is in Latin, name of the maker. And then over here, there is the war eagle on the right. It's a cracked bell, and at the bottom it says half dollar right below the bell ringer. This coin is a 90% silver coin, and John R. Sinek did the front and the back of these coins. It's worth about $10 just in silver alone, essentially the same silver content as the Kennedy halves when they first came out in 64. The 64 Kennedy half was 90% silver, but then the 65, 66 through 1970 were 40% silver, and the present ones from 1971 on were copper nickel clad copper. So don't sell this coin for under 10 bucks, that's for sure. Because it's worth 10 bucks just in silver alone, even if you melted it down. Now, this coin was preceded by the Walking Liberty half dollar. The Walking Liberty half dollar, the last one they made was in 1947. They made them from 1916 to 1947. Now, some of you with kind of sharp eyes might notice that they've seen this Liberty Bell before on another coin. And they did. They saw it on a coin that came afterwards. And it was only on that coin once, and that was on the Eisenhower half dollar, the bicentennial half dollar. You can see the bicentennial down here, 1776 to 1976. Well, on the back of the bicentennial half, they changed the Eisenhower back from the Eagle Landing on the Moon to the Liberty Bell in front of the moon. And when we look at it, we see this Liberty Bell here. And then we can look at the Liberty Bell on the Franklin, and let's see how similar they are. Well, it's the same bell, of course, but it's also kind of a very similar design. I believe that the engraver of this coin, Dennis R. Williams, says a DRW right there, used the back of the Franklin half as a model, because I know the actual Liberty Bell is the same thing, but this bell and this bell, just the way that they're engraved is so similar that I believe they probably used the same thing on them. And so that came out in only that one year in 1976 for the bicentennial. Now, if you are looking for these coins, one of the ways you can buy them sometimes is at a coin dealer or a silver dealer. They will sell them for a little over the silver value. Here's one that's in really good shape. This is a 1949. This coin is worth between $30 and $50 just in MS60. So, and if you get up to MS65, you're talking over 100. This is the second year they made it, and they only made about 9 million total, less than 10 million total the second year. The first year, 1948, is interesting because they only made about 7 million of them. And so those, if you can get an MS65 in the 1948D, you're talking about $100. But for some reason, the 1949 Phillies and Denvers are worth even more. So look for the 1949s, 1948s. That's where you can get the big money out of these. They're worth well over $10, and you'll hardly ever see a silver dealer or a coin dealer selling these in bulk for silver value alone. All right, that's all we have today from DC Coinwell International Coin Channel. Have a great day, and we'd love to have you subscribe to our channel and leave any comments you have in the comments section.